What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Godzilla Mode, and today I have another great video for you guys. All right, now in today's video I will be showing you guys the best settings to use in NBA 2K23. All right, now with these settings you will be able to green, you will be able to lock down anybody on the court, you will be able to dribble, you will be doing everything you need to do in NBA 2K23 and become unstoppable. All right, now look, before we get into it, make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and comment down below if these settings work for you guys and what, like, if you have any questions and what you need, and I will be able to help you guys. All right, and make sure you guys check out my Patreon link down below. The best defense and offense will be on there before the first week or second week of 2K23, and it will be out there very, very soon. All right, so the first thing that you guys want to do is go to settings right here, right? And the game difficulty, none of this really matters. None of this matters. Let me see, anything in settings, I don't think nothing in settings really matter. I think the pick and roll overlay is one underused setting that some people, it might be off for some people. Like when you hold in the left bumper, even if you're playing my career, the my career game, or if you're playing play now on my team, you want to see if you're holding the button, if they're actually setting a pick and roll. So just keep this on, do not cut it off. None of this stuff really matters. None of this really matters. Let's go to coach settings. Now what coach says, adaptive coaching engine. All right, this is a really key setting right here. All right, when this setting is on offense and defense, or offense only, defense only, do not have it on, because if you're running an offense, right, say you're running the Bucks 2018, which I don't know for sure if that's the best offense right now, but say you're running that, right, and you click the freelance to run it, when you click that, the CPU will run 7 seconds offense. So it will not run your set offense that you have on, that you want to run on the court. It will run the offense that it wants to run. All right, and the same thing with defense. If you're trying to run full court press, they will run man to man. When you're trying to run smother defense, they will run moderate. So you do not want this on. Leave this on off. All right, you want to manually do stuff. All right, now with the timeout situation, none of this stuff really, I mean, yes it does, yes it does, this does matter. When you, now, not with my career, but with, like, when you're playing play now and my team, timeout, player minutes, and substitution, you want to have this on manual, because when you're playing with the team, say the Lakers, right, and you're like, y'all going neck and neck, it's like, it's 15 to 15 second quarter, and the computer might take out LeBron or AD, right, and they might add, I don't know, Juan Toscano in the game. You do not want him in the game at this time, because you know if the opponent scores, you might be, it's going to be hard for you to score because LeBron's out the game, right? So you don't want this on auto. You want to have it on manual. None of this on auto. Leave it on manual, all right? Offense play vision, this is nothing, that's not really key. But this right here, offense play calling, defense play calling, and play calling messages, all right? Now, usually I have this on show all, right? And the reason why, when I run a play, say if I'm running Bucks freelance, right? Bucks 22 freelance. I want to know if a guy is in the corner sending screen. And when he sets the screens, I want to know that he's sending screen and what offense, what everybody's doing on the court, all right? So if that makes sense, that's what you guys want to have. You want to have it on manual and show off, all right? Because you really want, you're going to want that, all right? Late game fouling, you want to have this on manual. Like, having this on auto will hurt you so bad in the game. If you're running, say you're playing a comp game, right, of my team, and it's 65 to 63, and all you need is 2 points to score the ball. I mean, score the ball and tie the game up, right? It's 20 seconds left. When your opponent inbounds the ball, the CPU will intentionally foul him, right, which the opponent was going to have his best free throw shooter at the line, which probably will be Steph Curry or something, because he's the best card in the game right now. He's going to make both those free throws, and the reason you don't want this on auto and you want to have it on manual, because if the shot clock is still on, you will have time to get the ball back and you will have time to get a stop. So have this on manual, all right? And team communication, you want to have this on offense and defense. The reason why is because when you set a screen, or when your opponent set a screen, you want to know if you're the CPU defender, if he's going to go under the screen, go over the screen, and if you should switch, X switch, or things of that nature, all right? So have this on offense and defense. That's the best thing to have right now, all right? This right here, you have it on repeat on success, so therefore the next game it won't turn off your freelance from the last game, all right? So you want to have this on repeat on success, all right? Controller settings, what you guys want to have. Now this is a very key setting right here, all right? Now vibration, this really depends, up to you if you want to have it on or off. Shot meter, right? Now the thing this year was shot meter, I don't recommend having it on off or on, all right? Shot meter is completely up to you guys. Now, with it off, it helps you become a better 2K player, like, by far, when you have this on off. But this year with the meter, I feel like it's been really good so far. because shooting has been really, really hard this year. But one thing I noticed when you're using a meter on like Superstar and Hall of Fame games, if you have this on and you get a full meter, like I mean the fullest meter, and it doesn't green, you will miss the shot. So I do recommend having it on off. But like I said, it's really, really completely up to you. Shot timing. Now, another good meta thing that's been happening this year I've seen so far, shots and layups. When you have this on shots and layups, it's been easy to contest. I mean, to green layups on contested, like very, very contested shots. So I don't know, maybe layups and shots and layups is the new meta, but so far I'm going to use it on shots only. Now with shot timer release time, I've been using late hasn't, I haven't had no problems with it. I've been greening like usually, but one thing I do recommend is very early and very late, just try out whatever works for you guys, all right? Because a lot of stuff works different for different teams and different players. So like maybe with a team like the Warriors, they might release, it might be better using a different setting with them, but it might be a setting that works for all teams. But I haven't really tried out everything because late's been really, really working for me. So I'm just going to use late. Perfect release, none of this really matters. Now, shot meter type, what this is, you want to go to practice and just try out different shot meter types. All right, so you can see which one is better for you. Shot meter type is basically the meter. It's either going to be on the side of you, the top of you, or under you. All right, so just see which one you like the best. It's really just up to you. Pro stake function. With this setting, you do not want to have this on off. If you have this on off or default, I think that's what it is, defaults, bro, you will not be able to dribble. All right, you're going to be doing dribble moves and you're going to dribble into a shot, which you do not want. Only time you want to do that is if you have Steph Curry and you press X and he will do like a step back. Other than that, you do not want to do a behind the back dribble into a three-pointer. You do not want that. All right, so have it on dribble moves only. And none of this really matters. Oh, yes, it does. Double team reaction and help defense button function. All right. Have this on manual because if you have this on auto, when you hold your left bumper, and this works for current gen and next gen, when you do that, you do not, you want the computer or the teammates around you to react and double team. You do not want to have this on auto and when you click the button and they don't double team. All right, so if you have a guy stuck at half court and you want to get an 8-second violation, you hold the left bumper and he doesn't react, that's because it is on auto. So have it on manual and have it on double team. All right, you don't want it for call for help, have it on double team. All right, call for pick and roll versus fade, this is very key. Have this on manual. When you hold the left bumper on you in your offense, you want to ask for a screen. You don't want it on auto and you don't want them send the screen when they feel like send the screen. So have it on manual, all right? None of this really matters. None of this really matters. Maybe this does, but I've been having success without touching it, so this is even worse. Add defense assist strength. Now, it is on default 50, but you want to have this on 10, all right? 5 and 10. You do not want the CPU helping you on manual defense. Have it on 5 and 10 because if you have this on, if anything higher, when you're trying to play on-ball defense, the computer will literally slide your player away you don't want. So when you were trying to go left, the computer will go right a little bit. You might not notice it until you get like crossed up a lot and you were like, whoa, I'm not trying to go that way, but the CPU will be doing it for you. So have it on 10, all right? And for box out assist strength, this I really don't know. I usually just leave it where it's at, or you can have it at 100, or just see what actually works. But I really feel like 50, just leave it at 50 where it's at. Now with this is a very key setting, pass target openness. When you have this right default, say Klay Thompson is opening the right side corner and you got Steph Curry with the ball and you get a double team, when you press A or X, it don't matter what console or what gen, you want it to throw it to the most open player on the court. You don't want it thrown into the middle to Draymond Green that's got three guys on him and Klay Thompson is wide open. So have this at 80 and leave everything else where it's at, all right? So this is the best. These are the best settings in NBA 2K23 so far. I really feel like, you know, it will help you be guys. It will help you guys become a better 2K player all around. It will help you green shots better. It will help you do basically everything that you want to do in 2K. Help you become a better comp player, a better defensive player. Everything, even from it works for my career. You know, my team play now. Cause right now, I want to start playing my career, but I want to start playing more play now and get you guys more gameplay videos out and things of that nature. But so far, I just really been playing a lot of my team, so I can really, you know, show you guys more gameplay videos and things of that nature. So make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.